Today's mission will be to transplant geezer into this base for another old geezer. Let's see what's in the box. I think this is all plug and play solderless connections.
I hope everybody's doing as best as they can do. I count on nothing on a daily basis. That way I'm never disappointed. Expect nothing. Have low expectations. And you'll feel much better about yourself. Now, if I could only lobotomy myself. Lobota size? I don't know. How do you give yourself a lobotomy? Well, come on, geese. Come out of your box. What the hell? We love packaging, right? Everyone loves packaging. And we got another black box. Ooh, look at it all. We have two pots. We have a bunch of wire things. We got two pickups. We got an output jack. We got a bunch of paperwork. Let's see what they say. Well, out of the many choices, this would be us. One pickup. Master volume, master tone, front pickup, output cable, little thing like that, and this little crimpy wire connecty thing. But that's pretty much it. Black wire included with connector for bridge ground. Well, we're going to have to solder that to the bridge ground, unless we want to twist it together and have it fall apart later. What else have they got in here? Nothing. Okay, let's do it.
Okay, out with the old, in with the new. Get your headphones up loud. Power tools are going to be used in the making of this video. If you don't have power tools, well, get spinning your screwdriver. Don't be nervous. Don't be scared. See, like, you see my finger? It's always guiding the thing into where it needs to go. Right? So it's just like, you know, the Barney Fife. Takes the Barney Fife shake out of your hand. And you don't have your bullet and your gun, so you're gonna be fine. What's left? Oh, these gotta come off. It's a little slot guy. Where are you? Come out wherever you are. Boom. Pickup screws. I'm really hoping to do this without taking the strings off. I'm probably gonna have to loosen. But you know, if I was putting brand new high-end pickups in my base, maybe I'd get new strings too. I don't know. Release that guy. Come here. And I need a different wrench for that. Just, you know, notice how I'm like releasing everything and just letting it drop into the guitar as opposed to struggling with the pick guard with everything connected to it and then trying to remove it. There. Beautiful. Oh, release that, and then I should be able to sneak everything out of here. I should be able to. back in a moment.
So there's going to be one wire that's not plug and play, because we need that bridge ground. I'm just going to clip that off. And let's install the geezer stuff. I digress. That little squishy connector is to join those two ground wires. How convenient. The other thing they don't make mention of, I'm just going to compare the old with the new. Right, the geezers have much more depth to them, and they don't make mention of foam, but we need to put something under them. I'm just going to read through here again. They gave me a nice piece of foam that popped right out of the thing. And they're made to go in this direction. Just look again. Okie doke. The DG side, the AE side. Those are like this. All right, let's find that little jumper and make it happen. Then I'll find some foam.
This could mess you up if you're not paying attention. Notice, I hope the camera gets us, I'm shaking handheld here, how the white wire goes under the black and is on that side, but there's also those little arrow indicators on the connectors, which I'm following, but I looked at that and I went, oh, if you're following, oh, white wire, oh, it goes under the black wire, oh, okay.
Okay, the pickups are now in their holes. This one is marked volume. I gotta get all more, like, we love packaging. It's like the little pickup screws in their own little bag. This is in its own little bag, in a bag, on top of a bag, with a bag, in a box, which is in another box. I want that to point like that. Add one of these guys. You get the idea. And one of those guys. Oh, wait. I screwed up. You're supposed to put one of those guys on the bottom so that the thing doesn't stick out too far out of the pick guard. But at least I didn't do the whole thing before I spied that. Oh, man. Well, it is truly solderless. You do need something to release that ground wire. I guess you could do what I did and just cut it off and then strip it off. We'll get to that portion of the game in a minute. Okay, let's plug and play. That guy goes into the master tone. And looking for that little arrow again. If we screw that up, we'll be looking at it again. Come on, you can do it. There, that went on. Now, there's another little jumper, one of those guys, and that one has a little arrow on that side again. Did I get that correct? There we go. And then that connects to the center two positions with the little arrow pointing up. That last one is not used. Ground. Count 1, 2. 1, 2, 1, 2 goes there. Alright. And that's the one that connects to ground, where I'm going to do that last. Still kind of fiddly if you got big ham hands.
You might want to get a small child to help.
And then, what's this one for?
It's a spare. This, you're probably out of the movie by now, gets connected to the pickup, to the tone, and the ground. That's connected. Now, get this guy, and that guy, and that little nibbly thing here. One wire goes in there. The other wire goes in the other side. Like that. Now I need a pair of pliers to squish that with. Oh, let's use these. Okay, that's that. It should work. Let's plug it in before we put it all back together. It's quiet. I hear. Ooh, tone. Volume. Yes. It all works. Let's button it up. Well, as I just learned, I thought the pick guard would sleeve over top the pickups when they were installed, but no. The screw is, I mean, this is nice tight tolerance, but the screw hangs over the edge of that ear, and I couldn't get the pick guard to slide over, so I'd have to release all those and put them in after the pick guard's down in position. Just, you know, little things like that that make you go nuts. This guy's been here before. Just do a quick quick setup check-a-roo. We do not need to listen to that. And what do we got, folks? Neck relief. Could use a little twist. Just a bit. Once again, the weather's doing that changey thing that it does in the springtime. So, you know, we go from minus a lot to plus a lot, and then there. That might just do it. Turned pretty easy. A little bit more, but you know, if you live in places where the climate's changed, right, back to the last video about, you know, sprouting frets, well, that's what happens. Wood changes, the weather changes. If you live in a sloppy, juicy, moist climate, that's beautiful. Chances are you're good. If you have a really stable guitar, and I mean stable as in you can go cross country with it and it doesn't require any adjustments whatsoever, right? Yes. Something has happened here. A couple of the strings aren't quite right, but we'll fix that. Now we're good. Intonation's good. It's like a attempt at a geezer tribute. The old geez, definitely an innovator and one of my favorite bass dudes. So I quit this guy now. Let's clean it up a bit. And thanks to everybody who's subscribe, my patrons, thank you so much. Facebook group people have fun. Don't make me go in there and straighten yous out. Just try and get along. Oh, I know what I didn't do before I get all excited is I really didn't check the pickup height. I just sort of eyeballed it. And it could possibly go down a little bit. Yeah, all the things are below. Hold on a second. I got a sneeze coming. Oh, goodness. That was awful. 4 sneezes in a row. What's your all-time record for sneezing in a row? I think mine is like 6. Mine is like 6 times. If I sneeze more than 6 times, I'm probably going to die because that's the maximum I've sneezed. Ooh, ooh. What do we got there? It's looking pretty good. Down a little bit here. Just because the screw will go down, the pickup will not. I quit. Like I was saying, all the great links to things are below. Get a Day's World of Fun Stuff sticker. Help propagate the world with Dave's World of Fun Stuff stickers. Because I know they're all over the world now. And that makes me happy. Be good to each other. Be safe. Cheers, folks. Till next time.